Good morning, children.
How are you all? Now here I am taking the lesson, that is matter. Already we discussed about the properties of matter. Matter exists in three states: solid, liquid, and gas. The shape of the object or the arrangement, this depends upon the arrangement of the molecule, solid, liquid, and gaseous state. The state of matter, that is solid, liquid, and gas, depends upon the arrangement of molecules only inside it. Now here, already we discussed about the solid. Solids have fixed shape and fixed volume. Why? Because the molecules are closely packed, tightly packed in solids. There is no intermolecular space between the molecules. This is the reason the solids have fixed shape and fixed volume. Next coming to liquids. Second state of matter is the liquids, isn't it? Now here, liquids take the shape of the vessel. Liquids, you can milk is there, or water, oil, and daily use we'll use for 5-liter cans or 1-liter packet also we use, isn't it? So sachets you will get, even the water sachets also you will get in the market. So liquids take the shape of the container or glass, wherever, in whatever you are pouring, isn't it? So here, if you pour some water, now here see, this is a bottle, you are bringing the water bottle you are bringing, it takes the shape of the water bottle only. You are pouring the water in the bottle, so it takes the shape of the bottle only. You are bringing the different shapes, will be there for the water bottles. You are bringing, every student have different shape. You are saying, now pour this water into the glass. Pour the water into the glass, the water takes the shape of the glass. Or pour the water in the pot, it takes the shape of the pot only. So water is in liquid state. Water exists in liquid state. Now coming to properties of the liquids. Liquids move smoothly. We can say that liquids flows. Now you pour water. What happens? It flows on the floor fastly, isn't it? Flowing property will be there for the liquids. So most liquids around us, we can see the liquids, we can see the solids, we can see even the liquids also, isn't it? We can see the liquids also, and it takes the shape of the container, vessel, you can say container also, you can say. So here you will see the molecules in liquids are loosely packed compared to solids. Molecules in liquids are loosely packed, intermolecular space is more compared to solids. The molecules in liquids are loosely packed, and because of this reason, the flowing property you will get in the liquids. Okay? So molecules are loosely packed and intermolecular space is more compared to solids. So this helps in their free flow. This helps the liquids to flow easily, isn't it? So this is about the liquids. Next coming to gases. Now blow air on the palm. Warm air is coming out from your mouth. Can you see the air? No, we cannot see the air. We can't see the air. Can you see the color of the air? No, we can't see the color of the air also. See how when you are blowing the air. So gases do not have shape. Only we can feel it. When you blow air, you can feel air is blowing on your palm. But can you see? No, we can't see. Can you see the color? No, we can't see the color. Isn't it? We can't even see the color also. So gases do not have a shape. Gases do not have a shape. Gases do not have a shape. Air is a gas. Air is present everywhere. Right? Molecules in the air moves randomly. Randomly, isn't it? But can freely it moves. Any direction it moves. Isn't it? Any directions it moves. So everywhere, every empty space is occupies with the air only. Now here, so coming to uses of the air, where we use air for flying the kites. If air is not there, kites will not fly. If air is not there, what about our survival? We cannot survive without air. We cannot survive without air. Air is very important for breathing, very essential for breathing, isn't it? So here, so it moves randomly. So why? Because the molecules in air are far away from each other, far away from each other. Large molecular space is there in the molecules compared to solids and liquids. The molecular space is more fast and very far. The molecules are very far away from each other. This is the reason you will see the air is present everywhere. It moves randomly. Burning agarbatti. Agarbatti, if you burn, what happens? The smoke comes out. That smoke is spread everywhere in the house and the molecules are reaches to your nose and you will smell. Isn't it? So, this is about the solid, liquid and gases. So, I'll explain you the differences between solid, liquids and gases in the next class. Thank you.